Hey everyone, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can stop Facebook from sharing your personal data with other apps and websites. The Facebook scandal in early 2018 involving Cambridge Analytica, where as many as 87 million Facebook users had some of their personal information stolen, has caused people to pay more attention to the information they put on Facebook, and also to understand who has access to their Facebook data. In this video, I'll walk you through how you can see what sites and apps have access to your Facebook data and how you can stop sharing Facebook data with those sites and apps. In the first part of this video, I'll show you how to do this through the Facebook mobile app. And in the second part of this video, I'll show you how to do this using Facebook.com. First, let's walk through how to see which apps and websites Facebook is actively sharing your data with using the Facebook mobile app, and how to stop sharing your Facebook data with those sites. Step 1. Tap to launch the Facebook app on your iPhone, iPad, Android, Amazon, or Microsoft mobile device. Your Facebook home screen appears. Step 2. Select the menu icon in the lower right corner of the screen. The menu icon features three horizontal lines. A menu appears on the screen. Step 3. Scroll down to the bottom of the menu. Tap to expand Settings and Privacy, and then tap Account Settings. The Settings screen appears. Step 4. Scroll down to the bottom of the Settings screen, and then tap Apps. The Apps and Website screen is displayed. Step 5. Tap Logged In with Facebook towards the top of this screen. The Logged In with Facebook screen appears. Step 6. Select the Active tab toward the top of this screen if it isn't selected by default. A list of apps and websites currently able to access your Facebook data appear on the lower part of the screen. Tap View to the right of any of the websites or apps that can actively access your Facebook data to see more information about what data they have access to. An information screen associated with that site or app will be displayed. This screen displays a summary of information you're sharing with this site or app and what this site or app can do in Facebook on your behalf. For example, right now we're looking at all of the things the LinkedIn app has access to and actions it can take on my behalf in my Facebook account. I can see it has access to any information I'm sharing publicly, my list of friends, the city I live in, and my email address. I can also see that LinkedIn can post on my behalf. Any lightly shaded check marks next to these options are required to continue using a site or app with Facebook, but any dark shaded check marks are optional and can be turned off. For example, I'll remove the check mark to stop sharing my friends list, current city, and email address with LinkedIn, and I'll also remove permission for it to post on my Facebook wall. I'll tap Save to save my changes, and you can see the options I unchecked are removed. Tap the back arrow in the upper left corner of the screen to return to the Logged In with Facebook screen. Step 7. If you decide you want Facebook to stop sharing your information with an app, you can tap the circle to the left of the website or application in the active list. A blue check mark appears to the left of the app, and the Remove button to the right of the active section title turns dark blue. Tap Remove. A Remove screen appears, informing you that information on your Facebook page associated with that application may be deleted, and also that the app owners may still have access to any information that was previously shared with them. Tap the blue Remove button to verify that you want to stop sharing your Facebook information with this app. A Remove window appears, verifying that this site or app no longer has access to your Facebook information. Tap the blue Done button on the removed page. You'll be returned to the Logged In with Facebook page where the website or app you chose to stop sharing your Facebook information with is removed from the active list. Step 8. Tap the Removed tab in the Logged In with Facebook window. A list of all of the sites and apps you chose to stop sharing Facebook data with is displayed on the lower part of the screen. Tap any of the removed sites or apps to display a summary screen that shows when that site or app's data access was removed, your user ID associated with that app, the status of the site or app's data access, and who you need to contact if you want to ask that site or app to remove any of your Facebook data they may still be storing. Tap the back arrow in the upper left corner of the screen to return to the logged in with Facebook screen. Step 9. Finally, you can tap the expired tab in the logged in with Facebook window to view a list of all sites and apps whose access to your Facebook data has expired on the lower part of the screen. These apps do not currently have access to your data because their permissions expired. You can formally remove their permissions by tapping the circle to the left of any apps to display a blue check mark, and then tapping the blue remove button to the right of the expired section title. Or you can select an app or site where you want to reactivate their access to your Facebook data and then tap the blue renew access button in the center of the screen. And now, let's take a look at how to see which apps and websites Facebook is actively sharing your data with using Facebook.com and how to stop sharing your Facebook data with those sites. Step 1. Open your web browser, navigate to Facebook.com, and then log into your account. You'll land on the Facebook home screen. Step 2. Click the drop-down arrow to the right of your profile picture in the upper right corner of the screen. A drop-down menu appears. Step 3. Click Settings in the drop-down menu. The General Account Settings screen appears. Step 4. Tap Apps and Websites in the list of options on the left side of the screen. The Apps and Websites section appears on the right side of the screen. Step 5. Select the Active tab toward the top of the screen if it isn't selected by default. A list of apps and websites currently able to access your Facebook data appear on the lower part of the screen. Click View and Edit in the box associated with any of the websites or apps that can actively access your Facebook data to see more information about what data they have access to. An information screen associated with that site or app will be displayed. This screen displays a summary of information you're sharing with this site or app and what this site or app can do in Facebook on your behalf. For example, right now we're looking at all of the things the Forbes app has access to and actions it can take on my behalf in my Facebook account. I can see it has access to any information I'm sharing publicly and my email address. Any lightly shaded check marks next to these options are required to continue using a site or app with Facebook, but any dark shaded check marks are optional and can be turned off. For example, I'll remove the check mark to stop sharing my email address with Forbes. I'll click Save to save my changes. My changes are saved and the window disappears. Step 6. If you decide you want Facebook to stop sharing your information with an app, you can click to place a check mark in the radio box associated with any websites or apps that Facebook is actively sharing your personal information with. A remove button to the right of the action section title turns dark blue. Click Remove. A remove dialog box appears, informing you that information on your Facebook page associated with that application may be deleted and also that the app owners may still have access to any Facebook information that was previously shared with them. Click the blue Remove button to verify that you want to stop sharing your Facebook information with this app. A removed window appears, verifying that this site or app no longer has access to your Facebook information. Click the blue Done button on the removed page. You'll be returned to the Logged In with Facebook page where the website or app you chose to stop sharing your Facebook information with is removed from the active list. Step 7. Click the Removed tab in the Logged In with Facebook window. A list of all of the sites and apps you chose to stop sharing Facebook data with is displayed on the lower part of the screen. Click on any of the removed sites or apps to display a summary screen that shows when that site or app's data access was removed, your user ID associated with that app, the status of the site or app's data access, and who you need to contact if you want to ask that site or app to remove any of your Facebook data they may still be storing. Click Close to close the dialog box. Step 8. Finally, you can click the Expired tab to view a list of all sites and apps whose access to your Facebook data has expired on the lower part of the screen. These apps do not currently have access to your data because their permissions expired. You can formally remove their permissions by clicking to place a check mark in the radio box associated with any of the apps and then clicking the blue Remove button to the right of the expired section title, or you can select an app or site where you want to reactivate their access to your Facebook data and then click Renew Access at the bottom of the window. Congratulations! You now know how to stop sharing your personal Facebook data with other apps and websites through both the Facebook mobile app and Facebook.com. Thanks for watching. Leave your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. Click the video link on the right side of the screen to check out another video. Click the logo on the left side of the screen to subscribe to this channel to see more great videos like this one.